Happy Sabbath.
Želim vam blagoslovenu subotu.
We will be considering a little bit this topic of a prophetic voice for the last days.
Malo ćemo razmatrati ovu temu proročkog glasa za posljednje dane.
As Seventh-day Adventist, we believe that the Bible is our only rule of faith and practice.
Kao Adventisti sedmog dana, mi vjerujemo da je Biblija jedino pravilo naše vere i delovanja.
And even that it interprets itself.
I da ona sama sebe tumači.
So why you, as a Seventh-day Adventist, insist in having another prophetic voice for the last days? Tako, Is the Bible not sufficient?
Tako, zašto vi kao Adventisti sedmog dana insistirate na još jednom proročkom glasu, zar Biblija nije sama dovoljna?
After all that we need for salvation is in that book.
Na kraju svih krajeva, sve što nam je potrebno za spasenje se nalazi u toj knjizi.
We will be considering a little bit this question, why, although we accept the Bible as our only rule of faith and practice, we also believe in the prophetic gift for the last days.
Malo ćemo razmatrati to pitanje zašto mi kao Adventisti sedmog dana, premda verujemo da je Biblija jedino pravilo naše vere, ipak insistiramo na tome da postoji još jedan proročki glas za posljednje dane.
And what function does it, this prophetic gift have in regard to the Bible, in relationship to the Bible?
I koju funkciju ovaj proročki dar ima u odnosu na Bibliju?
And just one more question.
I još jedno pitanje.
Can somebody be saved without believing in Ellen White?
Može li neko da bude spašen bez da veruje Ellen White?
Let's start with a Bible passage that's very well known, Amos 3:7.
Hajde počnemo sa biblijskim tekstom koji je veoma poznat, Amos 3:7. Zaista Gospod ništa ne čini bez da to otkrije slugama svojim prorocima.
Well, if we study our Bible, we will see that in prophetic times we had canonical and non-canonical prophets. I mean, in biblical, in regard to the Bible.
Kada posmatramo biblijsko vreme, mi imamo kanonske i nekanonske proroke.
And what is the difference between canonical and non-canonical prophets?
A koja je to razlika između kanonskih i nekanonskih proroka?
Canonical prophets help to write portions of the Bible.
Kanonski proroci su napisali određene delove Biblije.
Do you have some examples?
Imamo li primere?
Yes. Moses.
Da, Mojsije.
Isaiah.
Isaija.
Jeremiah and so on.
Jeremija i tako dalje.
And we have non-canonical prophets.
A imamo i nekanonske proroke.
And they did not write parts of the Bible. Do you have some examples?
I oni nisu zapisali ni jedan deo Biblije. Da li imamo takve primere?
Yes.
Nathan.
John the Baptist.
Jovan Krstitelj.
It's interesting that the only two prophets that were taken to heaven without facing death were non-canonical prophets.
Zanimljivo je da jedina dva proroka koja su uzeta na nebo bez da su okusili smrti su bili nekanonski proroci.
Enoch and
Enoch i
yes.
Ilija, Elijah.
But there is something interesting about this. People make a big deal out of canonical and non-canonical prophets.
Ljudi nekada prave krupno pitanje od toga ko je kanonski, ko je nekanonski prorok.
But remember that when prophets were still alive.
Ali setite se da dok su proroci bili još uvek živi,
there was no distinction between canonical and non-canonical prophets.
Nije se pravila razlika između kanonskih i nekanonskih proroka.
The distinction between canonic and non-canonic prophets,
ta razlika između kanonskih i nekanonskih proroka,
came into existence after the formation of the Old Testament canon and then later on of the New Testament.
Se desila nakon formiranja starozavetnog kanona i onda kasnije nakon novozavetnog kanona.
Of course, you can say that before the canon was of the Old Testament canon was formed, the writings of Moses already had some authority in the New Testament. Paul was recognized even by Peter and so on. But a canonical status is something a later development.
Naravno, vi možete reći da Mojsejevi spisi su imali svoj autoritet u već u starozavetnom periodu i takođe u Novom Zavetu. Pavle je prepoznat od strane Petra kao kanonski pisac, ali još uvijek taj pojam kanonskih i nekanonskih pisaca je nastao tek kasnije.
So the question was not during the lifetime of the prophets, are you a canonical prophet or not?
Tako da za vreme života proroka pitanje nije bilo jesi li ti kanonski ili nekanonski prorok.
The question is are you a true prophet or a false one?
Pitanje je bilo da li si ti pravi istinski prorok ili lažni.
So does canonical prophet and non-canonical prophets have the same authority, prophetic authority?
Tako da li kanonski i nekanonski proroci imaju isti autoritet, odnosno the same what?
Authority.
Same, isti autoritet.
If you say yes, I say no. If you say no, I say yes, just to be against you.
Ako vi kažete da, ja ću reći ne. Ako vi kažete ne, ja ću reći da, samo da bih bio nasuprot vama.
So you know already what is the answer.
Tako da znate šta je odgovor.
Yes and no.
I da, i ne.
From the perspective of the authorship, they have all the same authority.
Iz perspektive autorstva imaju svi isti autoritet.
Because in final instance, God is the author of all the inspired writings.
Jer na kraju svih krajeva Bog je autor svih inspirisanih spisa.
But from a functional perspective,
ali iz funkcionalne perspektive,
there is a difference.
Postoji razlika.
I accept Ellen White as a prophetic, as a prophet, because I believe that she is in full authority, in agreement with the Bible.
Ja prihvatam Ellen White kao proroka jer smatram da je u potpunosti u skladu sa Biblijom.
And not the other way around.
A ne obratno.
I would not accept the Bible because the Bible is in agreement with Ellen White.
Ja ne bih prihvatio Bibliju zbog toga što je Biblija u skladu sa spisima Ellen White.
God and his wisdom chose the 66 books of the Bible as the canon, the rule, the standard.
Bog je u svojoj mudrosti odabrao 66 knjiga biblijskih kao standard, kao pravilo.
To evaluate all other supposed prophets.
Da bismo evaluirali sve ostale proroke koje se mogu pojaviti.
In our statement of fundamental beliefs, number one,
u našem osnovnom verovanju broj 1,
we recognize the authority of the Bible.
Mi prepoznajemo autoritet Biblije.
But it says also that the Bible promises that the gift of that the spiritual gifts would be given to the church.
Ali takođe piše i da Biblija obećava da će se duhovni darovi davati crkvi.
And here you have the fundamental belief number 18.
I onda ovde imamo osnovno verovanje broj 18.
It might not be your question, but some people ask why this statement has been rephrased.
Možda to nije vaše pitanje, ali neki ljudi pitaju zašto smo drugačijim rečima formulisali ovo osnovno verovanje.
I even helped to rephrase it a little bit.
Čak sam i ja učestvovao u tom parafraziranju, odnosno drugačijem formulisanju ovog verovanja.
Some people say, well, you are lowering the authority of Ellen White here in this statement.
Neki ljudi su rekli, pa vi malo spuštate autoritet Ellen White u ovoj izjavi.
That's not the case.
To nije istina.
We are saying there that Ellen White speaks with prophetic authority, and I think that that's enough.
Mi tu kažemo, Ellen White govori sa proročkim autoritetom i smatram da je to dovoljno.
You know, before the statement here used to say that Ellen White is an authoritative source of truth.
Ranije ovdje pisalo da je Ellen White autoritativan izvor istine.
I see that statement as a little bit difficult.
Nekako vidim da tu imamo neke poteškoće.
First of all, the word authoritative is not so common in many languages.
Prvo, reč autoritativan nije uobičajena u mnogim jezicima.
And to be translated into other languages sometimes it's difficult.
I nekada prevođenje na druge jezike je teško.
Into Portuguese and Spanish it was translated as authorized.
Na portugalski i španski se prevelo kao autorizovano.
But then comes the question, who authorizes it?
I onda se postavlja pitanje, a ko to autorizuje?
And the expression source of truth can be misunderstood.
A može se pogrešno razumjeti i izjava izvor istine.
So Ellen White is your source of truth and is not a Bible?
Znači, Ellen White je vaš izvor istine, a nije Biblija?
So to avoid this kind of misunderstandings, we simply put over there speaks with prophetic authority, and that's the case.
Tako da bismo izbili te nesporazume, mi smo jednostavno napisali govori sa proročkim autoritetom, i to je ono što je slučaj.
But this is just a parenthesis here to, in case you have this kind of questions.
Ali ovo je samo onako jedan dodatak u zagradi, ako imate to pitanje.
The point is that we accept Ellen White because the Bible speaks that the prophetic gift would be part of the would be given granted to the church in general.
Mi prihvatamo dar proročki dar Ellen White zato što Biblija govori o tome da će taj dar biti dat crkvi.
Back to our first question.
Da se vratimo na naše prvo pitanje.
Why a prophetic voice for the last days?
Zašto proročki glas za posljednje dane?
You can have other answers to it and perhaps even better. I would like to share with you three of them.
Možda vi imate bolje ili drugačije odgovore, ali evo ja bih podelio sa vama tri odgovora.
The first one is due to the complexity of the world.
Prvi razlog je povezan sa složenošću našeg sveta.
If you ever fly to Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Ako ikad budete leteli u Buenos Aires, u Argentinu.
And you have a connecting flight to the north of Argentina. It can be Cordoba, Corrientes, or Rosario, whatever.
I onda recimo idete za Rosario na sever Argentine, imate još jedan let.
And the day is clear.
I lepo se sve vidi, dan je onako.
Don't miss the chance of looking down through the window to see the huge delta of the Paraná River.
Nemojte propustiti priliku da gledate dole na ogromnu deltu Paraná reke.
In the widest part of the delta it has 80 kilometers.
Na najširem delu delte to ona je široka 80 km.
And it is the extension is 300 km.
A produžetak je 300 km.
With several canals as you can see here.
Sa raznim kanalima koje ovdje možete vidjeti.
When a ship comes from overseas to the harbor in Buenos Aires, they local pilot is provided or captain to guide the boat throughout the canal that is deep enough for navigation.
Kada brod dolazi sa nekog drugog kontinenta i onda se tu uključuje jedan lokalni moreplovac koji pomaže da brod može da prođe kroz te kanale koji su vrlo specifični.
Even today with all the GPS they still have the pilot that helps the ship to sail.
Čak i danas kad imamo GPS i sva ta moderna pomagala, još uvijek taj jedan dodatni kopilot dolazi i sprovodi brod da može da prođe bezbedno kroz te kanale.
The history of the world can be compared with a huge river.
Istorija sveta se može usporediti sa jednom ogromnom rekom.
That really goes through valleys and mountains and so on.
koja ide i kroz planine i kroz doline.
And before reaching the ocean of eternity,
i pre nego što stignemo do tog okeana večnosti,
it forms a huge philosophical, ideological, religious and whatever else delta.
Formira jednu ogromnu filozofsku, religioznu, psihološku deltu.
Do you know how many Christian denominations we have today?
Znate li koliko hrišćanskih denominacija imamo danas?
Just within Christianity?
Samo unutar hrišćanstva.
The most reliable study of it.
Najpouzdanija studija toga
showed that by mid the year 2014
je ukazala na to da do 2014. godine
there were already 45,000 different Christian denominations all claiming to be based on the Bible.
Postojalo je 45.000 hrišćanskih denominacija koje su sve tvrdile da su zasnovane na Bibliji.
If Christianity would be a homogeneous religious body, I would have my doubts.
Kada bi hrišćanstvo bila jedna homogena hrišćanska zajednica, religijsko telo, ja bih imao neke svoje sumnje.
But Christianity has become a mosaic.
Ali hrišćanstvo je postalo jedan mozaik.
I have not studied so much Hinduism.
Nisam puno proučavao hinduizam.
Hinduism is pluralistic by nature.
Ali hinduizam je pluralistička religija po svojoj prirodi.
You have literally millions and millions of gods.
Vi doslovno imate milione bogova.
Because in every different place you can have a god.
Jer na svakom drugom mjestu vi možete imati drugog boga.
But outside Hinduism, I don't think that any other of the great world religions is so divided than Christianity.
Ali osim hinduizma, mislim da nijedna od velikih svjetskih religija nije tako podijeljena kao hrišćanstvo.
People say that today, with the growth, we already are over 47,000.
Ljudi kažu da danas sa prirastom i porastom imamo već preko 47.000.
So I believe that the prophetic gift of Ellen White was given us not to replace the Bible, but to keep us faithful to it.
Tako da smatram da proročki dar Ellen White nije tu da zameni Bibliju, nego da nam pomogne da budemo verni Bibliji.
If I were a non-Christian to become a Christian,
ako bih ja bio neko ko nije hrišćanin, pa onda hoću da postanem hrišćanin,
I would be almost lost with all this confusion.
Bio bih prilično izgubljen u toj celoj konfuziji.
What the Bible actually says.
Šta u stvari Biblija kaže?
The second reason,
drugi razlog,
is the temptation of culture.
Jeste iskušenje kulture.
Culture has exercised a strong temptation to all us as Christians.
Kultura je imala, je poslala jedno snažno iskušenje za sve nas hrišćane.
I believe that the most difficult topic in theology is culture.
Mislim da je najteže pitanje u teologiji kultura.
How we as a church relate with our culture.
Kako mi kao crkva se odnosimo prema našoj kulturi.
And that has been the temptation throughout the ages.
I to je bilo iskušenje kroz vekove.
A famous German theologian and historian called Ernst Troeltsch.
Poznati nemački teolog i historičar koji se zove Ernst Troeltsch.
He studied how post-apostolic Christianity really was tempted by culture and really embraced it.
Proučavao je kako je u ranom hrišćanstvu, post-apostolskom hrišćanstvu, hrišćanstvo bilo u iskušenju od uticaja koje se nalaze oko njega i kako se ono promenilo.
There is a French author also, Jacques Ellul.
Postoji i francuski autor koji se zove Jacques Ellul.
And Ellul. And his book, this is the English version of it, translation.
I ovo je engleska verzija njegove knjige, prevod.
He asks a question.
On postavlja pitanje.
How does it come that Christianity of the Christendom,
Kako to da hrišćanstvo od hrišćanskog sveta
has generated a culture completely in opposite to the teachings of Christ and the apostles.
Je u stvari proizvelo kulturu koja je potpuno suprotna onoj koja je Hristova i suprotna njegovom učenju.
And we have also an Seventh-day Adventist author, Leroy Froome.
Imamo adventističkog autora Leroy Froome.
And he has an interesting statement also.
I on ima zanimljivu izjavu.
While the church is evangelizing the world,
dok crkva evangelizira ovaj svet,
the world is secularizing the church.
Svet sekulariše crkvu.
The world is evangelizing the church as well.
I svet evangelizira na svoj način crkvu.
But the way how it evangelizes is by secularizing us.
Ali ono kako svet nas evangelizira jeste kroz sekularizaciju.
Here we have a few diagrams that can help us to understand it better.
Ovdje imamo par dijagrama koje nam pomažu da to bolje razumemo.
Sociological studies of religion have demonstrated.
Sociološko proučavanje religije je pokazalo
that usually a church starts to reform the culture in which it exists, coming closer to the to revelation.
Obično crkva počinje da menja kulturu i svet u kojem se nalazi, približavajući se onom idealu otkrivenja, odnosno Svetog pisma.
But in the second century of their existence,
ali u drugom veku svog postojanja,
when the pioneers are gone and those who knew the pioneers do not exist,
kada pioniri odu i oni koji su bili blizu pionira, ni njih više nema,
the same church tends to lose its identity and be reabsorbed by the culture that originally intended to reform.
Ta crkva ima tendenciju da se vrati, ispusti bliže toj kulturi koju je u stvari htjela da reformiše.
Do you believe that a post-apostolic Christianity had the same commitment than the apostles?
Da li verujete da post-apostolski period crkve je imao isto ono predanje Božjem delu kao i kod apostola?
And that a reformed tradition has the same commitment than the reformers?
I da onaj postreformacijski period ljudi u crkvi su imali isto tu predanost Božjem delu kao kod reformatora.
And that we as Seventh-day Adventists today have the same commitment as our pioneers said.
I da mi danas kao Adventisti sedmog dana imamo istu predanost Božjem delu kao naši pioniri.
There are many things today that we don't regard as sin as in the past.
Postoje mnoge stvari koje mi više ne posmatramo kao da su greh, što smo posmatrali tako u prošlosti.
We have today coffee without caffeine.
Imamo danas kafu bez kofeina.
Alcohol free beer.
Pivo bez alkohola.
And we have also sinless sin.
I imamo bezgrešni greh.
So many things in the, of the past that were considered sinful are no longer.
Tako da mnoge stvari koje su u prošlosti bile posmatrane kao greh, nekako više nisu greh.
Of course there are some options.
Naravno, postoje neke opcije.
Maybe our pioneers were too radical and now we reached the balance.
Možda su naši pioniri bili previše radikalni, a mi smo došli u neku ravnotežu.
Or there is the natural development like we are not dressing like Christ and the apostles did.
Ili je to neki prirodni razvoj, jer se mi ne oblačimo kao što su se oblačili Isus i njegovi apostoli.
But there is a possibility that we are closer and closer to our culture, even against the principles of God's word.
Ali postoji mogućnost da smo mi sve bliži i bliži našoj kulturi, čak i nasuprot principima Bože reči.
And that's not so easy to define these details.
A ove detalje nekad nije lako ni definisati.
Jacques Ellul in his book points out something that I like very much.
Jacques Ellul u svojoj knjizi ističe nešto što mi se jako sviđa.
While I am going down here, coming closer and closer to my culture.
dok se ovdje spuštam sve bliže i bliže mojoj kulturi.
And the distance between my practice here and the Bible is quite significant.
I razmak između moje prakse i onog na što me Biblija poziva je prilično veliki.
And we have then the option of going back to the Bible.
I imamo opciju da se vratimo Bibliji.
And that means revival and reformation.
A to podrazumeva probuđenje i reformaciju.
Or what usually happens?
Ili što se obično desi?
I don't adjust myself back to the Bible.
Ja se ne prilagodim opet Bibliji.
But I reread the Bible from the perspective of my own practice.
Nego ja čitam Bibliju iz perspektive moje sopstvene prakse.
And that's what usually happens.
I to se obično dešava.
The Bible has to adjust to myself.
Biblija mora meni da se prilagodi.
And as I mentioned today,
i kao što sam danas
pomenuo, what I like of the Bible is normative.
Ono što se meni sviđa u Bibliji, to je normativno.
Everybody should follow it.
To svako treba tako da radi i da sledi.
What I don't like,
a ono što se meni ne sviđa,
is cultural and just for that time.
To je samo kulturološki i to je za ono tamo vreme.
You have another diagram that is in the same line.
Imamo i drugi dijagram koji je isto u tom pravcu.
The history of Christianity can be written from this perspective.
Istorija hrišćanstva se može napisati iz ove perspektive.
As I mentioned before, a church starts.
Kao što sam već ranije spomenuo, crkva počinje.
Comes close to revelation.
Približava se otkrivenju.
And then it comes to the starts to decline.
I onda počinje da opada.
And to be reabsorbed by culture.
I da se opet uklopi u svoju kulturu.
Some people like it.
Neki ljudi to vole.
Otherwise it would never happen.
Inače to se nikad ne bi desilo.
Our church is very obsolete. We have to modernize it to speak the language of the 21st century.
Naša crkva je jako zastarela. Moramo da ju modernizujemo i da govorimo jezik 21. veka.
Other ones do not like it.
Neki drugi to ne vole.
These people here are selling our church.
Ovi ovde ljudi prodaju našu crkvu.
We have to reform it.
Moramo da ju reformišemo.
And then reform movement or independent ministries start to show up.
I onda se pojavljuju reformatorski pokreti ili nezavisne neke službe.
They do not intend to establish a new church.
Nemaju oni nameru da uspostave novu crkvu.
They want to reform the church itself.
Oni žele samu tu crkvu da reformišu.
The church does not react.
Crkva ne reaguje.
Then they become really independent.
Onda oni zaista postanu nezavisni.
And eventually a new church.
I konačno nova crkva se pojavi.
And they forget that they will pass to the very same sociological process. And other ones would come from out of them as well.
I onda zaborave da će oni proći kroz taj isti sociološki proces i da će drugi izaći iz njih.
Out of Israel came Judaism.
Iz Izraela je proistekao judaizam.
Out of Judaism
iz
came
judaizma
Christianity.
Je došlo hrišćanstvo.
Out of Christianity
iz hrišćanstva,
well, we can add the Orthodox Church as well, that's split.
Možemo da dodamo i pravoslavnu crkvu koja se odvojila.
Came the Reformation.
Došla je reformacija.
Out of Anglicanism came Methodism.
Iz anglikanizma došao je metodizam.
Out of Methodism came the Christian connection.
Iz metodizma je došla hrišćanska veza.
Out of the Christian connection and several others, we came.
Hrišćanske veze i još nekih drugih crkava, mi smo nastali.
And what assurance do you have that we as Seventh-day Adventists will be the honor exception that will break this rule and that we will not be replaced by any other denomination?
I koju sigurnost mi imamo da ćemo mi kao adventisti biti izuzetak u ovom celom procesu i da nećemo mi isto imati novo odvajanje od nas?
Just because Ellen White says so.
Samo zbog toga što Ellen White kaže tako.
Remember that the Jews also believed that they would be the remnant people forever.
Sećate se, i jevreji su verovali da će oni biti Božji ostatak za uvek.
How far we go down in this process?
Koliko duboko ćemo se spustiti u ovom procesu?
Of all Christian denominations that I know of,
od svih hrišćanskih denominacija za koje znam,
the only one that has the concept of a eschatological shaking is the Seventh-day Adventist Church.
Jedina crkva koja ima koncept eschatološkog rešetanja je adventistička crkva.
The shaking will clean the church and prepare for the final events.
Rešetanje će očistiti crkvu i pripremiti ju za poslednje događaje.
When I was a student at a boarding school academy in the south of Brazil,
kada sam bio student na jugu Brazila u internatu,
we had a pastor that had a week of prayer.
Imali smo pastora koji je vodio molitvenu sedmicu.
And in one of his sermons he mentioned that the problem of the church today is not lack of members but too many uncommitted members.
On je spomenuo da problem crkve danas nije nedostatak članova, nego previše članova koji nisu predani.
Of course, if all the country of Serbia would become Seventh-day Adventists, praise the Lord.
Naravno, ako bi cela Srbija, svi u njoj postali adventisti, slava Bogu.
But they should be committed Seventh-day Adventists.
Ali treba da budu predani, posvećeni adventisti.
We cannot repeat the story of Constantine filling our churches with pagan people without any kind of commitment.
Mi ne možemo da ponovimo priču Konstantinovu gde on ispunjava crkvu sa paganima koji nisu predani hrišćanstvu.
You remember that in the time of Gideon they started with 32,000.
Vi se sećate da u vreme Gedeona počeli su sa 32,000.
And then it went down.
I onda se spustio broj.
And down.
I još se jedan put spustio.
And finally 300 were the ones.
I u konačnici smo imali 300 njih.
We have today, like we say in German, too many Mitläufers.
Danas mi imamo previše onih, kako se to kaže na nemačkom, Mitläufera ili onih koji onako usput idu s vama.
Mitläufer is like this. The procession is going on.
Mitläufer je onaj koji ovako ide jedna procesija, ide jedna kolona.
And the cat and the dog are together there.
Who is there?
The cat and the dog.
Aha. Tu su i mačka i pas.
They do not know why they are there.
Ne znaju oni zašto su tu.
But they feel good and they are together.
Ali dobro im je tu i druže se sa ostalima.
So we have too many people that are like this. So nice to be in the club of Jesus.
I mnogo je njih koji kažu, pa lepo je biti u Isusovom klubu.
The shaking will take care of it and prepare the church for the final events.
Rešetanje će se pobrinuti za tu situaciju i pripremiti nas za poslednje događaje.
If you would ask me what is the most important function of Ellen White for the Seventh-day Adventist Church,
ako biste me pitali koja je najbitnija funkcija Ellen White za adventističku crkvu,
is exactly what is here.
Onda je to tačno ono što je ovde prikazano.
She is a prophetic voice trying to avoid us to be victims of our culture.
Ona je taj proročki glas koji nam pokušava pomoći da izbegnemo da postanemo žrtve naše kulture.
She is saying, please don't allow the culture to rob your commitment from the Bible.
Ona kaže, molim vas, nemojte dopustiti kulturi da vam ukrade vašu predanost Bibliji.
Remain faithful to the Bible.
Ostanite verni Bibliji.
Don't allow the same story that happened to the other Christian denominations to happen to you.
Nemojte dopustiti da se vama ponovi ono isto što se dešavalo drugim hrišćanskim denominacijama.
So besides being the complexity of the world,
uz ono što smo spomenuli, složenost sveta,
the temptation of our culture,
iskušenje naše kulture,
a third reason is that Ellen White provides a prophetic interpretation of Scripture.
Jeste da Ellen White nam daje proročku interpretaciju pisma.
I spoke a little bit about this before.
Malo sam o tome govorio ranije.
I believe that Ellen White uses the Bible in the same way, I mean, the Bible the same way as the New Testament uses the Old Testament, or a similar way.
Ja bih rekao da Ellen White koristi Bibliju na isti ili sličan način kao što Novi Zavet koristi Stari Zavet.
Can Ellen White be considered a theologian?
Možemo li Ellen White posmatrati kao teologa?
It depends what you understand by theologian.
Zavisi od toga šta podrazumijete po terminom teolog.
If theologian is somebody that masters the original languages,
ako je teolog nekog koji dobro vlada originalnim jezicima,
and does scientific exegesis,
i radi naučnu egzegezu,
she would not qualify.
Ona ne bi mogla da zadovolji taj kriterijum.
She only knew English, nothing else. As far as languages.
Ona je samo poznavala engleski i ništa drugo što se tiče jezika.
But although she did not have access to the original languages,
ali premda znači nije imala pristupa originalnim jezicima,
as a true prophet she has access to the source of truth.
Kao pravi prorok ona ima pristup izvoru istine.
And that allowed her to have some kind of insights that are very significant in regard to the Bible.
I to je dopustilo da ima određene uvide koji su vrlo značajni za sadržaj Biblije.
If you want to read in the book that was just given out, the one the gift of prophecy in scripture and history.
Dakle, ako budete čitali ovu knjigu koju ste svi dobili, dar proroštva u istoriji
if you want to read an interesting chapter in that book,
ako želite jedno zanimljivo poglavlje da pročitate u toj knjizi,
read the one by Richard Davidson.
Čitajte poglavlje Richarda Davidsona.
Where he speaks about insights in the Old Testament original that were not available at that time and only people that knew the original language could grasp.
Onda čitajte kako je ona imala uvid u određene stvari iz Starog Zaveta koje nisu bile poznate u to vreme i koje se mogu zaključiti samo iz originalnih jezika.
Ellen White also says that if we would be faithful to the Bible, her prophetic gift would not be needed.
Ellen White također kaže da ako bi mi bili verni Bibliji, njen proročki dar ne bi bio neophodan.
But because we neglected the Bible, God provided this additional light to bring us back to the Bible.
Ali pošto smo zanemarili tu svetlost, Bog nam je dao proročki dar da bi nas vratio Bibliji.
I like, for instance, this classical, very well-known statement by Jemison in his book A Prophet Among You.
Meni se sviđa ova klasična izjava od Halsela Jemisona o svojoj knjizi o proročkom daru, tri osnovne svrhe ili namere.
He says that Ellen White was intended to direct attention to the Bible.
On kaže da Ellen White tu da bi usmjerila našu pažnju ka Bibliji.
But never in the history of the world we had so many Bibles available.
Pa nikada u istoriji nismo imali toliko Biblija na raspolaganju.
Why to call attention to the Bible?
Zašto da se usmerava pažnja na Bibliju?
Never before the Bible was so available, but also not so neglected.
Nikada Biblija nije bila toliko na raspolaganju, ali u isto vreme toliko zanemarena.
Old pastors used to tell a story.
Stari pastori su znali da ispričaju sljedeću priču.
That one of the pastors went once to visit an old lady.
Jedan od pastora je otišao da poseti jednu staru damu.
And when in the old fashion he came to the lady and then said, "How is your spiritual life?"
I u tom starom stilu on je došao kod te sestre i rekao, "Kakav je tvoj duhovni život?"
Do you read the Bible every day?
Da li čitaš Bibliju svaki dan?
Oh yes.
O da.
Do you pray also?
Da li se također moliš?
Okay. So before I leave, could you bring your Bible so that I could read a passage here and pray with you?
Da li pre nego što ja odem bi mogla da neseš tvoju Bibliju da pročitam jedan odeljak i da se s tobom pomolim?
And the lady went and to a place there and picked up the Bible and came back.
I ova gospođa otišla po Bibliju i vratila se sa njom.
But she was rejoicing.
Ali ona se radovala.
Pastor, God sent you here to my place.
Pastore, Bog te poslao ovde u moj dom.
6 months ago I lost my glasses.
Pre 6 meseci ja sam izgubila svoje naočare.
Those old very thin glasses.
To su bile vrlo tanke naočare.
I forgot it in my Bible.
I zaboravila sam ih u mojoj Bibliji.
And now that you ask my Bible, I found them.
I sada kad si me pitao za moju Bibliju, evo našla sam moje naočare.
And she pretended to be reading the Bible every day, is what she said to the pastor at the beginning.
A u stvari pravila se pred pastorom kao da je čitala svoju Bibliju svaki dan. To mu je rekla na početku.
There was a time to be a member of the youth society of our church.
Bilo je vreme kada ste bili član društva mladih u našoj crkvi.
You had to memorize the sequence of all Bible books.
Trebalo je da naučite na pamet redosled svih biblijskih knjiga.
I still recall my father in German mentioning Galate, Efeza, Filipa, Kolosa, and that's the way that keeps in my mind to find the books in the New Testament.
Ja se još uvek sećam kako je moj otac na nemačkom nabrajao redosledom knjige Novog Zaveta, Galatima i onda dalje.
You had to know also by memory the Ten Commandments.
I morali ste na pamet da znate da se zapovesti.
Psalm 23.
23. psalam.
The several other portions of the Bible, even the three angels' messages.
I razne druge delove Biblije, uključujući trostruku anđelsku vest.
But now I, in some ministerial councils, I tell the pastors.
Ali sada ja na nekim sastancima pastora i kažem pastorima.
If you preach a sermon of those minor prophets,
ako biste propovedali propoved iz onih malih proroka,
give much time, plenty of time for people to locate it.
Onda dajte dosta vremena ljudima dok pronađu tog malog proroka.
And it starts in Genesis and go to Revelation. And so in final they leave the Bible open on Psalm, not to give the impression that they cannot find the book.
I onda, znači, oni krenu od prve Mojsije, pa dođu do Otkrivenja, pa onda dalje vrte i na kraju otvore psalme, da bi dali utisak da su nešto pronašli, a u stvari nisu pronašli pravu knjigu.
Dwight Nelson, in one of his sermons in the good old days over there, he mentioned that Seventh-day Adventists are specialists in the book of Genesis.
Dwight Nelson u svojoj propovedi je rekao kako su Adventisti sedmog dana specijalisti za prvu Mojsijevu.
I don't know if you have this same, you do the same here.
Ne znam da li je to i tako i ovde.
But in many places, when it comes to December 31,
ali u mnogim mestima, vezano za 31. decembar,
our church has a special worship between the old year and the beginning of the new year.
Naša crkva ima posebne službe vezane za kraj stare godine i početak nove.
And the pastor then makes an appeal.
I onda pastor uputi apel.
Let's read our Bible now this new year.
Hajde sada da ove nove godine pročitamo našu Bibliju.
And everybody's committed to do so.
I svako kaže da, tako ćemo da uradimo.
So in January 1, I read 3 chapters. Wow.
I na 1. januara ja pročitam svoje 3 glave.
January 2, another 3 chapters.
2. januara još 3 glave.
And so it goes for a while.
I tako neko vreme ide.
Then I slow down to 2 chapters.
Pa onda malo usporim na 2 glave.
1 chapter.
1 glavu.
And before I finish the book of Genesis, I stop.
I pre nego što dođem do kraja prve Mojsije, ja prestanem da čitam.
Till the next year when a new appeal comes.
Do sledeće godine, do kada se uputi novi poziv.
So Seventh-day Adventists are specialists in the book of Genesis.
I zato su Adventisti sedmog dana specijalisti za prvu Mojsijevu.
I had a friend and I asked him, are you doing that kind of Bible reading every day? I asked him.
Jednog prijatelja sam pitao, da li ti tako svaki dan čitaš Bibliju?
Yes, I am already in Genesis 1, verse 2.
Da, ja sam upravo kod prve Mojsijeve, 1. glave, 2. stiha.
And that was for a long time.
A to je potrajalo malo.
Well, going back, she also helps to understand the Bible.
Ona takođe pomaže da razumemo Bibliju.
But does the Bible not interpret itself?
Ali zar Biblija ne tumači samu sebe?
I answer this question with another one.
Ja ovo pitanje odgovaram kroz drugo pitanje.
Or going back to what we already said.
Ili vraćamo se na ono što smo već rekli.
If Christianity would be a single homogeneous body, I would have my doubts.
Ako bi hrišćanstvo bilo jedno homogeno telo, ja bih imao svoje sumnje.
But with all this kind of religious fruit salad that Christianity became.
Ali sa svom ovom voćnom salatom religijskom što je hrišćanstvo u stvari postalo.
Never before we needed so much a prophetic gift to keep us safe.
Nikada nam nije više bio potreban proročki dar da bi nas sačuvao bezbedne.
And to apply Bible principles in our lives.
I da nam pomogne da primjenimo biblijske principe u našim životima.
The weakness of Christianity and of our own spiritual life.
Slabost hrišćanstva u našem duhovnom životu
is probably to have a nice speech.
Jeste što imamo lep govor,
but not necessarily a nice a coherent practice.
Ali nemamo koherentnu, dobru, kvalitetnu praksu.
I can preach a very nice, beautiful, moving sermon on how to love your enemies.
Mogu da ispropovedam jako lepu, dirljivu propoved o tome kako da volimo naše neprijatelje.
But after my sermon is over,
ali nakon što se moja propoved završi,
and I am back to real life,
i vratim se u stvarni život,
and I met a real terrible guy that hates me the most,
i sretnem onog strašnog tipa koji me najviše nervira,
I forget all my speech.
Zaboravio sam svu onu svoju propoved.
Mahatma Gandhi even stated,
Mahatma Gandhi je čak izjavio,
that he would be willing to become a Christian,
da bi bio voljen da postane hrišćanin,
if he would really found Christians, met Christians that really live the Sermon on the Mountain in the practical life.
Ako bi stvarno sreo neke hrišćane koji žive u skladu sa Hristovom propovedi sa gore.
What the world propovedi. Needs to see.
Ono što svet treba da vidi
in us as Christians,
u nama kao hrišćanima,
the same coherence of life that was in Jesus Christ, who not only preached the truth, but he was the truth.
Jeste ta ista koherentnost onoga što je bilo u Hristu. Ne samo da je propovedao istinu, nego da je bio istina.
Ellen White also helps us to understand world history and the teachings of the Bible within the framework of the great controversy.
Ellen White nam također pomaže da razumemo istoriju sveta i veliku borbu u tom okviru velike borbe.
We already spoke about the dimensions of the great controversy today, this morning.
Govorili smo već o dimenzijama velike borbe jutros.
I would just call your attention to some analogies, five analogies that I think that help us to understand the function of Ellen White.
Htio bih da vašu pažnju usmjerim na pet analogija koje nam pomažu da razumemo funkciju Ellen White.
The first one is the lighthouse analogy.
Prva analogija je analogija svetionika.
In the stormy days that we are living.
U ovim burnim danima u kojima živimo.
I think that she provides a special light for this last day so that we can sail safely to the everlasting harbor.
Verujem da nam daje posebnu svetlost da bismo mogli da bezbedno jedrimo ka onoj večnoj luci.
It can be compared also to a microscope.
Može se usporedi i sa mikroskopom.
If you read the Gospels together with the Desire of Ages,
ako čitate Evanđelja zajedno sa čežnjom vekova,
you see several details there that Ellen White points out that is not so clear.
Vi vidite tamo neke detalje koje Ellen White ističe koje nam inače nisu tako jasni.
From a historical perspective, I know that a great controversy is our philosophy of history.
From which perspective?
From our Adventist perspective.
Iz naše adventističke perspektive meni je jasno da je velika borba taj neki okvir kako mi posmatramo istoriju.
But I cannot apply it very consistently because I cannot see the intentions of people.
Ali ja to ne mogu da primjenim jako konzistentno, jer ja ne znam koje su namere ljudi koje su oni imali i ne mogu da gledam iza scene,
But Ellen iza White zavese. Provides it.
Ali Ellen White nam to daje.
In regard to the cross, for instance,
na primjer, po pitanju krsta,
and the baptism of Christ, she says that the devil was in person there.
Ili, na primjer, vezano za Hristovo krštenje, on nam kaže da je Sotona tamo bio u jednoj u liku jedne osobe.
Another classic illustration used by Vandermann, but it was really from Sarah, from the end of the 19th century, somebody by that name, is the analogy of the telescope.
Jedna druga analogija koju Vandermann, pastor Vandermann koristi je analogija teleskopa, još krajem 20. veka.
But who really started for the same first way was a lady called Sarah. I forgot her last name in the end of the 19th century.
Oh, yeah, not McIntyre?
No.
Not that another. Okay.
Is a health reformer. She wrote an article. I even have the original. Mm-hmm. I mean a copy of it.
Right. Dobro, uglavnom, znači, onaj koji je prvi koristio tu analogiju je jedna zdravstvena reformatorka sa kraja 19. veka.
A telescope does not add stars to the sky.
Teleskop ne dodaje zvezde na nebo.
Just allows us to see better the ones that we cannot see without it.
Samo nam dozvoljava da vidimo one koje možda ne bismo videli golim okom.
I like to compare Ellen White's writings as a filter, a prophetic filter.
Ja volim da usporedim spis Ellen White sa jednim proročkim filterom.
A filter does not provide water. I mean, does not create water.
Filter nam ne stvara vodu.
Just cleanses the water that is already there or purifies it.
Samo čisti vodu koja već postoji.
The problem is not with the Bible.
Problem nije u Bibliji.
Is with our human prejudice and tradition that we read into the Bible.
Zbog naših ljudskih predrasuda i već ranijih pretpostavki i grešaka, mi dodajemo neke stvari Bibliji.
So she tries to avoid us to read this kind of garbage into the Bible.
I ona nam pokušava pomoći da to smeće ne dodajemo Bibliji.
And then comes the analogy of the GPS.
A onda imamo još analogiju GPS-a.
The passage of Isaiah 30:21 is very meaningful.
Ili navigacija, znači Isaiah 30:21 je veoma smislan.
It says when you are trying to go this way or the other one, you will hear a voice saying, "No, this is the way."
I tamo piše da ako hoćete ići jednim putem ili onim drugim putem, vi ćete čuti glas koji će vam reći, "Ovo je put, njime idite."
Walk on it.
Njime idite.
The GPS has this, the GPS really does not create a road.
Navigacija ne stvara put.
But if you try to go this way, or the other one, it brings you back to the road.
Ali ako pokušate da idete na onaj put ili na onaj tamo drugi put, ona vas vraća na onaj pravi put.
So I believe that Ellen White can be compared to a prophetic GPS to keep us safe with the Bible.
Tako da verujem da Ellen White može da bude uspoređena sa jednom navigacijom koja nas uvek vraća ka onom biblijskom putu.
And then our final question.
I onda naše konačno pitanje.
Can somebody be saved without accepting Ellen White?
Da li neko može biti spašen bez da prihvati Ellen White?
Yes.
Da.
Martin Luther will be in heaven and never heard about Ellen White.
Martin Luther će biti na nebu, a nikad nije čuo za Ellen White.
Ellen White even has at least some five statements where she comments on Romans 2:14.
I Ellen White ima barem nekih pet izjava gdje ona komentariše Rimljanima 2:14.
Where she says that in heaven will be people that never heard the name of Jesus.
Gdje ona kaže da će na nebu biti ljudi koji čak nikada nisu ni čuli ime Isus.
But follow the light that they had.
Nego su sledili svetlost koju su imali.
And those, according to the passage, says that those did not, that who did not have knowledge of the written law, the conscience works.
U tekstu tamo piše da oni nisu poznavali pisni zakon, nego su ga imali u svojoj savesti.
If this is the case with Christ, imagine with Ellen White.
Ako je to slučaj po pitanju Hrista, pa onda možete zamisliti tek po pitanju Ellen White.
You know that one of the principles of answering questions.
Jedan od principa za odgovaranje pitanja.
If a question is wrong, you should first correct the question before answering it.
Ako je pitanje pogrešno, onda trebate prvo da ispravite pitanje pre nego što ga odgovorite.
So the question is not accepting Ellen White or believing in Ellen White.
Pitanje nije da li mi prihvatamo ili verujemo Ellen White.
The real question is can I reject a messenger of the Lord and still be in a safe ground?
Pitanje jeste da li ja mogu da odbijem vesnika gospodnjeg i još uvijek da budem na bezbednom tlu.
This passage is very crucial.
Ovaj biblijski tekst je presudan. Čitamo u Luki 10:16. Ko vas sluša, mene sluša. I ko se vas odriče, mene se odriče. Ako se mene odriče, odriče se onoga koji je mene poslao.
I already mentioned a little bit about this passage, I think was last evening.
Nešto sam već o ovome spomenuo, da li beše sinoć.
Let's suppose that I am in sin.
Pretpostavimo da sam ja u grehu.
And you can, and the Holy Spirit impresses you to come to me and speak to help me out in this situation.
I Sveti Duh vam progovori da dođete kod mene, da mi progovorite, da mi pomognete u toj situaciji.
And I said I am not interested in your opinion.
I ja vam kažem, mene ne zanima tvoje mišljenje.
Go back the same way you came.
Vrati se putem kojim si došao.
Am I rejecting you?
Da li ja odbijam vas?
Yes, I am.
Da.
But not only.
Ali ne samo.
I am rejecting the Holy Spirit that impressed you to come and speak to me.
Ja odbijam i Svetoga Duha koji je vas osvedočio da dođete i da mi progovorite.
If this is the case between us,
ako je to slučaj između nas,
I think it's valid also when God calls somebody as his special messenger or prophet.
Mislim da je to takođe validno i za osobe koje Bog pozove kao svoje posebne vesnike ili proroke.
And then let's end with a story and a Bible passage.
Hajde završimo sa jednom pričom i sa jednim biblijskim stihom.
Let's imagine that there is a couple that loves each other very much.
Hajde pretpostavimo da postoji jedan bračni par koji se jako voli.
Could be like you over there, no?
Možda kao ovo dvoje golupčića ovde.
And then the guy is sent with an army or whatever to a very remote place.
I onda ovog muškarca pošalju veoma daleko, na primjer, sa vojskom.
There is no internet.
Nema interneta.
There is no telephone.
Nema telefona.
Only once a week the mail arrives.
Samo jedanput sedmično stiže pošta.
When he comes over there,
kada on dođe tamo,
he speaks to his new friends.
On sa priča sa svojim novim prijateljima.
I have a girlfriend. That's the nicest creature in the universe.
Ja imam devojku koja je najlepše stvorenje u svemiru.
And people are impressed with his words. Very much impressed with his words.
I ljudi su jako impresionirani njegovim rečima.
And then the mailman comes. Then the mailman comes with a letter.
I onda dolazi poštar sa pismom.
He receives the letter.
On dobija pismo.
Just puts in a drawer.
Stavi ga u ladicu.
Not even opens the envelope.
Čak ni ne otvara tu kovertu.
But continues saying that he loves very much, is very much in passion with his girlfriend.
Ali nastavlja govori kako on jako voli svoju devojku.
The following week, two letters.
Sljedeće sedmice, dva pisma.
He does not read, just keeps them.
Ne čita, samo stavi dole.
And other letters more.
I još više pisama stiže.
He doesn't read any of them.
Nije ništa od tih pisama on ne čita.
Do you, Do you think that we can take seriously what this guy is saying?
Da li mislim da možemo da ozbiljno slušamo to što on govori?
You know that God has sent us letters of love in the Bible?
Vi znate da nam je Bog ljubavna pisma poslao u Bibliji?
And in the books of Ellen White?
A i u knjigama Ellen White.
We claim to love God very much.
Mi tvrdimo da volimo Boga veoma.
But we never, not always are so consistent or coherent with our claims.
Ali nismo uvek baš konzistentni ili dosledni sa našim tvrdnjama.
This should be the time for us to consider and to really put in practice what we claim.
Ovo bi trebalo bude vreme kada bismo trebali da razmotrimo i da u praksi sprovedemo to što tvrdimo.
You should have a personal plan.
Treba da imate lični plan.
Maybe you could have your companion book.
Možda možete imati svoju priručnu knjigu.
You have to wait in a bank in a line over there or elsewhere. You can read a few paragraphs.
Možda dok čekate u redu u banci ili negde drugde, možete da pročitate nekoliko redova.
Or whatever plan.
Ili kakav god drugi plan da imamo.
But you should have a personal plan for yourself.
Ali treba da imate svoj lični plan.
And if you do so,
i ako tako bude,
I think that you can claim this wonderful promise of 2 Chronicles 20:20.
Smatram da možete da za sebe primenite ovo obećanje iz druge dnevnika 20:20.
You read it.
Verujte Gospodu Bogu svojemu i bit ćete jaki, verujte prorocima njegovim i bit ćete srećni ili napredovat ćete.
May the Lord bless you and myself that we may really be faithful to this wonderful life that we light that we received from the Bible as well as from the writings of Ellen White.
Nekada bi nam Bog pomogao da zaista budemo verni ovom divnom svetlu koje smo dobili iz Biblije, ali i iz pisa Ellen White.
Amen. Why don't you finish with a word of prayer?
Hajde da ustanemo se pomolimo.
You pray.
Okay. Oče naš nebeski, hvala ti na tvoje velikoj ljubavi, hvala ti što je tvoj sveti dan počeo i što možemo da uživamo u njemu. Hvala ti što, zato što si nas voleo, ti si podizao jednog proroka za drugim. Počevši od Mojsija, preko svih drugih vernih ljudi kao što su bili Isaija, Jeremija, koji su često i stradali jer ih je narod tvoj odbacivao, pa nekada čak i ubijao i progonio, ti si iznova i iznova zarana slao proroke ka nama. A tvoj dragi sin je postavio pitanje kojega od proroka ne kamenovaše, ne odbaciše, ne prezreše. I Gospode, hvala ti što si u ovo posljednje vrijeme ti podigao još jednog proroka. Ne da bi našu slobodu ograničio, nego da bi nam dao veću radost i veći kvalitet i lepotu života, jer kad smo god poslušni tvoje objavi, mi bivamo blagosloveni. Zato te molimo da tvog proroka ne odbacujemo, da ga ne zanemarujemo, jer je to slično kao i odbacivanje, nego da primimo taj veliki blagoslov koji je rođen kroz delovanje tvog svetog duha. Ti si izabrao proroka, ti si ga pozvao, ti si mu dao vizije i snove, oko 2000 čak. I zbog toga hvala ti što ćeš nam pomoći da kao crkva obratimo pažnju na tu dragocenu svetlost koju si nam dao u ove posljednje dane. Ovo se sve molimo u ime našeg Gospoda i Spasitelja Isusa Hrista. Amin.